morning to all my loving students. Welcome back to our English class. Today, we are going to learn lesson number 9 of First Flight textbook, Madam Rides the Bus. This short story was written by Vallikannan, the pseudonym or pen name of R.S. Krishnaswamy, a Tamil writer, journalist, critic and translator. In 1978, he was awarded the Sahitya Akademi Award for Tamil. The lesson, Madam Rides the Bus, is about a brave 8-year-old girl who had a strong desire and along with it the courage to fulfill that strong desire. The story brings us recounts of how innocently but responsibly she fulfilled her deepest desire and her experience. How an incident makes her realize the reality of life and death. Okay, come on children, let's know what was her strong desire and how she achieved it. Lesson number 9, Madam Rides the Bus. There was a girl named Valliamma who was called Valli for short. She was 8 years old and very curious about things. Her favorite pastime was standing in the front doorway of her house, watching what was happening in the street outside. There were no playmates of her own age on her street, and this was about all she had to do. But for Valli, standing at the front door was every bit as enjoyable as any of the elaborate games other children played. Watching the street gave her many new, unusual experiences. So this story is about a girl and her name was Valliamma and she was called Valli for short. She was 8 years old and she wanted to know many things. Always she would stand in the front doorway of her house and would see what was happening outside, and there is no playmates for her of her own age. Watching the things gave Valli many unusual experiences and she enjoyed that watching than the elaborate games other children played, and this gave Valli a new unusual experiences. So let's check what was the unusual experiences that the street looking gave to Valli. The most fascinating thing of all was the bus that traveled between her village and the nearest town. It passed through her street each hour, once going to the town and once coming back. The sight of the bus filled each time with a new set of passengers was a source of unending joy for Valli. So when Valli was watching outside, she had a fascinating sight, and the fascinating thing was the bus which was traveled between her village and the nearest town, and that bus passed through her street each hour, once it was going to the town and once it was coming back, and this sight of the bus filled each time with a new set of passengers. Each time the bus has new set of passengers, and this was a source of unending joy for Valli. So what was the unending joy and what was the source of unending joy for Valli? The bus which is traveled between her village and the nearest town with a new set of passengers was a source of unending joy for Valli. Day after day she watched the bus, and gradually a tiny wish crept into her head and grew there. She wanted to ride on that bus, even if just once. This wish became stronger and stronger until it was an overwhelming desire. So day after day Valli was watching this bus, and gradually a tiny wish came into her head. And what was the wish? And that wish is growing there in the head, and she wanted to ride on that bus even if it is for just once. And this wish on riding the bus, that wish became stronger and stronger, and until it was an overwhelming desire. It was a strong desire. So Valli wanted to ride on the bus. Valli would stare wistfully at the people who got on or off the bus when it stopped at the street corner. Their faces would kindle in her longings, dreams and hopes. If one of her friends happened to ride the bus and tried to describe the sights of the town to her, Valli would be too jealous to listen and would shout in English, "Proud, proud." Neither she nor her friends really understood the meaning of the word, but they used it often as a slang expression of disapproval. So already we know that Valli had a strong desire in her mind, that was she wanted to ride on that bus. And Valli would stare wistfully. Wistfully means longingly look at people who got on or off the bus when it stopped at the street corner. And their faces would kindle in her longings, dreams and hopes. The faces of the passengers, how some kindle. Kindle means set alight. Here, feelings. She is feeling, she is having that faces in her longings, dreams and hopes. And also, if one of her friends happened to get an opportunity to ride on the bus and that friend is describing about the bus journey, then Valli would be too jealous of her and she would shout in English. What was Valli shouting? Proud, proud. Neither she and nor her friends know the meaning of the word proud, proud, but they use that word as showing their disapproval to something. So if any friend of Valli is describing her experience, describing the experience of this bus journey, Valli would become too jealous and she shout at her with loud, loud. Even though they did not know the meaning of the word, they used it to show their disapproval to something. Slang expression means informal words often used with a close group, within a close group. It's a slang, it's a colloquial word that is used in a group of people. Over many days and months, Valli listened carefully to conversations between her neighbors and people who regularly used the bus, and she also asked a few discreet questions here and there. This way, she picked up various small details about the bus journey. And for fulfilling her strong desire for traveling in the bus, over many days and months, Valli carefully listened to the conversation between her neighbors who regularly used that bus. And she also asked a few discreet questions. Discreet questions means careful questions. Some important questions here and there. She collected some information from the passengers. And this way she picked up various small details about the bus journey. So let's look out what are the details Valli got about that bus journey. The town was 6 miles from her village. The fare was 30 paise on way, which is almost nothing at all, she heard one well-dressed man say. But to Valli, who scarcely saw that much money, from 1 month to the next, it seemed a fortune. The trip to the town took 45 minutes. On reaching town, if she stayed in her seat and paid another 30 paise, she could return home on the same bus. This meant that she could take the 9 o'clock afternoon bus, 1 o'clock afternoon bus, reach the town at 1:45 and be back home by about 2:45. On and on went her thoughts as she calculated and recalculated, planned and replanned. So these are the information that Valli got from the passengers. What are the informations? The town was what is the distance of the town from her village? The town was 6 miles from her village and the fare for one side was 30 paise. And a person is saying that it is almost nothing. It's a small amount, but for Valli it is a huge amount because she didn't saw such huge amount. And the trip to the town took 45 minutes. So the trip to the town took 45 minutes. And she also know how she would return. If she had another 60 paise, she can return to her home. And if she is taking the bus, the 1 o'clock bus in the afternoon, that bus will reach at the town at 1:45, and she can back to her home at 2:45. This way, she calculated and recalculated, planned and replanned for riding in the bus. Well, one fine spring day, the afternoon bus was just on the point of leaving the village and turning into the main highway when a small voice was heard shouting, "Stop the bus! Stop the bus!" and a tiny hand was raised commandingly. The bus slowed down to a crawl and the conductor, sticking his head out the door, said, "Hurry then, tell whoever it is to come quickly." "It is me," shouted Valli. "I am the one who has to get on." By now, the bus had come to a stop and the conductor said, "Oh really? You don't say so." "Yes, I simply have to go to town," said Valli, still standing outside the bus. "And here is my money." She showed him some coins. Okay, but first you must get on the bus," said the conductor. And she stretched out a hand to help her. "Never mind," she said. "I can get on by myself. You don't have to help me." So Valli already planned her trip on the bus, and we can see on fine spring day, the afternoon bus was just on the point of leaving the village to the main highway. Then we can hear a small voice. And whose voice was this? Yes, it is the voice of Valli, and the voice was a commanding voice, and she said, "Stop the bus, stop the bus." And the bus slowed down to a crawl, and the conductor, his head out the door, said, "Hurry then and tell me who want to get in the bus." Then Valli said, "It was me, the one who has to get on." So seeing Valli, a small child, the conductor was surprised, and he said that, "Oh really, you don't say so." But Valli again said that, "Yes, I have to go to town and I have the money with me." Then the conductor said to Valli, okay, first you have to get into the bus. And he stretched a hand to help Valli, but Valli don't want the help of anyone. So she said, "I can get on by myself. You don't have to help me." The conductor was a jolly sort, fond of joking. "Oh, please don't be angry with me, my fine madam," he said. "Here, have a seat right up there in front. Everybody move aside, please. Make way for madam." The conductor was a jolly man and he loved of joking. He understood that Valli spoke with pride. So he offered Valli a front seat, calling others to make way for madam. So the conductor called Valli madam. It was the slack time of day and there were only 6 or 7 passengers on the bus. They were all looking at Valli and laughing with the conductor. Valli was overcome with shyness. Avoiding everyone's eyes, she walked quickly to an empty seat and sat down. So, it is a slack time of that. Slack time means a time when there is not much work. It's an afternoon time. So, it is a slack time. So, there is only a few passengers, 6 or 7 passengers in the bus. They were all looking at Valli and the passengers were laughing with the conductor. And Valli felt some insulting. That means she was overcome with shyness, and avoiding everyone's eyes, she walked quickly to an empty seat and sat down there. So Valli is in the bus now and she is ready to ride on the bus. The conductor called Valli with respect in a joking way as madam. That is why the title is there, Madam Rides the Bus. Okay. "May we start now, madam?" the conductor asked, smiling. Then he blew his whistle twice and the bus moved forward with a roar. So again the conductor asked something to Valli in a joke way, that "May we start now, madam?" And he blew his whistle twice and the bus moved forward. It was a new bus, its outside painted a gleaming white with some green stripes along the sides.
inside the overhead bars shone like silver. Directly in front of Valli, above the windshield, there was a beautiful cloak. The seats were soft and luxurious. So Valli studied everything in the bus. It had a soft and comfortable seat. It had a beautiful cloak above the windscreen. And the stripes. There are some gleaming white with some green stripes along the sides. And overhead bars are shone like silver. Valli devoured everything with her eyes, but when she started to look outside, she found her view cut off by a canvas blind that covered the lower part of her window. So she stood up on the seat and peered over the blind. So Valli wanted to look outside, for she started to look outside, but she found her view cut off by a canvas. She cannot look at outside and see the beautiful scenery is there. So Valli had to stand up. Then only she can peer over that blind canvas there. The bus was now going along the bank of a canal. The road was very narrow. On one side there was a canal, and beyond it palm trees, grassland, distant mountains and the blue sky. On the other side was a deep ditch, and then acres and acres of green fields, green as far as the eye could see. So Valli look outside through the bus, through that canvas, through the blind canvas there, and she saw palm trees, mountains and the blue sky, and the another side there was acres of green fields. Oh, it was all so wonderful. And Valli feel it was all wonderful to see such a beautiful sight through the bus. Suddenly she was startled by a voice. "Listen, child," said the voice. "You shouldn't stand like that. Sit down." But suddenly she heard a voice and she was frightened of the voice. And the voice said, "Listen, child, you shouldn't stand up like that. You have to sit down." Sitting down, she looked to see who had spoken. It was an elderly man who had honestly been concerned for her, but she was annoyed by his attention. "There is nobody here who is a child," she said haughtily. "I have paid my 30 paise like everyone else." The conductor chimed in. "Oh, sir, but this is a very grown-up madam. Do you think a mere girl could pay her own fare and travel to the city all alone?" Valli shot an angry glance at the conductor and said, "I am not a madam. Please remember that. And you have not yet given me my ticket." "I will remember," the conductor said, mimicking her tone. Everyone laughed, and gradually Valli too joined in the laughter. The conductor punched a ticket and handed it to her. "Just sit back and make yourself comfortable. Why should you stand when you have paid for a seat?" So, the man who shouted, told Valli to sit on her seat. Suddenly, an elderly person asked Valli not to stand up, calling her child. Valli got angry when that old man is calling her child. She replied proudly that she was not a child and she had paid full amount, full fare like others. The conductor, who was always humorous, told the elderly person that Valli was a grown-up madam. And Valli looked at the conductor angrily. She told the conductor that she was not a madam and he had not yet given her the ticket. She reminded him that "you have not yet given me the ticket." So the conductor gave her the ticket and tell her that if you had paid for the seat, why are you standing there? Okay. "Because I want to," she answered, standing up again. "But if you stand on the seat, you may fall and hurt yourself when the bus makes a sharp turn or hits a bump. That is why we want you to sit down, child." "I am not a child, I tell you," she said irritably. "I am 8 years old." Of course, how stupid of me. 8 years, my." So the conductor advised Valli to sit there, but Valli is saying that I want to because I am I want to stand up, that is why I am standing here. But the conductor is again advising her that if you are standing, you may fall and hurt yourself when the bus makes a sharp turn or hit a bumps. That is why we are telling my child to sit down. So Valli became again irritated by hearing the child. So she again said that I am not a child, I am 8 years old. So for that, the conductor is again tell that, of course, you are 8 years old one, and he was a stupid. How stupid I am. The bus stopped, some new passengers got on, and the conductor got busy for a time. Afraid of losing her seat, Valli finally sat down. So the bus stopped at another stop, and some passengers got on, and the conductor was busy with his own job. So Valli is afraid of losing her seat, so she finally sat on the seat. An elderly woman came and sat beside her. "Are you all alone, dear?" she asked Valli as the bus started again. Valli found the woman absolutely repulsive. Such big holes she had in her earlobes and such ugly earrings in them. And she could smell the betel nut the woman was chewing and see the betel juice that was threatening to spill over her lips at any moment. Yeah, who could be sociable with such a person? So, some new passengers came in the bus. And at the next stop, an elderly woman came and sat beside Valli. The woman asked Valli if she was alone. Valli looked at the woman. She had some ugly earrings and also she had betel nut in her mouth, and the betel juice was likely to come out of her mouth. At this, Valli was not alike. That was, she has a fear that the betel juice will spill over her. So she's thinking that how could be sociable with such a person. "Yes, I am traveling alone," she answered curtly, "and I have got a ticket too." "Yes, she is on her way to the town," said the conductor with a 30 paise ticket. "Oh, why don't you mind your own business?" said Valli, but she laughed all the same and the conductor laughed too. So for the reply of the woman's question, Valli said that she was alone and she had got the ticket also. Then the conductor also ordered with a laughing that she is going to town and she had the ticket. She paid the 30 paise. For that, Valli asked him why he didn't mind his own business, and then she laughed with the conductor. That means Valli is also liked the joke made by the conductor towards her. But the old woman went on with her travel. "Is it proper for such a young person to travel alone? Do you know exactly where you are going in town? What is the street? What is the house number?" "You needn't bother about me. I can take care of myself," Valli said, turning her face towards the window and staring out. So the old woman again told Valli that it was not proper for her to travel alone, and she also asked her Valli about her house and where she want to go in the town and which is the street and what was the house number. Valli was not liked by the question of this woman, so she replied that she needn't bother about her. Valli turned her face towards the window and she staring outside through the window. Okay, so she is not liked to tell all the things, all her intention to that old woman. Already she did not like the old woman because of her appearance, and the woman is asking her some question. For that, Valli is not ready to give the answer. She was irritated by the questions made by this old woman. Okay, my dear children, let's wind up for today. You have to read the lesson carefully and try to write the answers of the activity questions. Be safe, take care, and thank you for watching the video.